Good evening, YouTubers. Well, there's been lots of comments on the Alex Belfield video that we made earlier, and lots of people are coming out with things, and I said, in the interest of transparency, you know, people should be allowed to watch court cases. Now, the televising of Crown Court cases has never happened. You know, I remember years ago watching the Crown Court. It was a TV drama in the 70s. Very popular, lots of people watched it. And people would be very interested in watching the cases. Now, they have come to the point where they are televising the sentencing, which is good, it's a step in the right direction. But, I watch a guy called the Body Language Guy. I don't know if anyone out there watches him. Very famous guy. And he's always analysing people like Meghan Markle, for example, and Harry. And he's other people as well, famous people. And he's going, oh, look at the body language, the look that she gave, and look what the... And they're pointing things out. Now, people like him are very valuable because people like him could be watching witnesses for the prosecution in these court cases and going, ah, look at that. Look what he did there. And they can be picking and analysing whether they believe what he said is true or not. I mean, just saying something under oath doesn't mean a thing. You can swear by Almighty God on the Holy Bible. You might not even be a Christian. You might not be so what? Did he do that? Oh, yeah, he did. And he didn't. So you've got to have scrutiny and transparency, and people have got to look. It's all very well having 12 people who have been press ganged and stuck on a jury, and they're like this, they're fed up and they just want to go home. Right, but you could have swathes of people across the world watching these cases and picking up on things and saying things and putting their input in and say, oh, look, when he said this and he said that, did you see what he did? Oh, I don't like this. Look, why did he do that? Get him back in the dock. Ask him that again. You know, and because at the end of the day, with a court case, you want the truth to come out. You know, you want transparency. You don't want it all hidden behind wigs and cloaks. No, the door's shut. You can't come in with a camera. You can apply for the transcripts. We'll send you the transcripts of the case in about 6 months' time when we get round to it. And the typist has to... No. I want the cameras right there from the beginning all the way to the end. And they're going to cry. They're going to go, no, the witnesses need protecting. Well, you can pixelate their faces out, can't you? And they're reading their names out. Of course you're reading your name out. If you're giving evidence in court, it should be on file and so should your face. And they go, oh no, the witnesses will be intimidated by the cameras. They won't even see the cameras. They won't even know. Well, they know the cameras are there, but they won't see them. So many people, when you get a camera out and point it at them, they turn into an instant clown, or they go, woo, and they're off. And so the cameras should be there, but you can't see them. And so the people just get up and they give their testimony. You know, if you don't want to give testimony, then don't go to court and give evidence. So all these things have got to be taken into account, and they've been doing it in America for years and other countries. And I think it's about time they did it in Great Britain, you know, because people can get stitched up. You know, I've been in court and I've had some twat come standing in the court giving evidence against me, right? And he's gone and back a big drama queen telling a load of fucking lies, and the magistrate, like a sponge, soaking it all up. And when I go to cross-examine him, he goes, stop, you can't ask him that, you can't ask him this, you can't ask him the other. You think, well, what the fuck am I here for? Why don't you just fucking find me guilty, you cunt?